Freddio.com.
All right, guys, I'm getting ready to go into 10th and Piedmont. We're getting ready to go watch a celebrity boxing match with my boy. I don't even know their names, but yeah, they gonna be here. They gonna be boxing. You know, they loving hip hop people. So yeah, my girl Collie Red told me to come in. She said Lamar Odom is gonna be here and a few other greats. You know, so I was like, let me go check them out, see who gonna come out. So anyway, y'all, before we do anything, I need y'all to make sure you hit like, subscribe, most importantly, the bell, because if you don't hit the bell, you won't see the rest of my videos. My lips looking a little ashy. Anyway, we're going to go ahead and go in because I'm late as usual. And we're going to go and just show you around. So I think it looks like they're getting ready to set in. So I'm going to hurry up and go in and get it going. All right.
We got a whole legend over here in the rap game. And look,
man,
I got this star and hosting the TV show Cedars. The one and only Peter Gunz, make some noise, y'all.
Horny ass Brooklyn motherfuckers. I need my five, Paulo. I need my five now, Paulo. Up front.
Peter, go get me out. Fuck
out. I need my five, Paulo, now. Paulo, come on, Paulo. I need it. I need it now. Cash at me, Zell at to me. Let's do it tonight.
So what's up, guys? This is good.
Let's go.
Listen, man, at the end of the day, we probably tell your man what it is. Tell him
what it is.
It's an easy five for me. Let's go. The number.
Yeah.
Oh my God. People, we here live. As you see, we got all kind of people here. They got into it. It's really messy, y'all. That was really messy. But yeah, it's really bad.
Rich?
No, nigga,
gonna suck up shit. Like, I wasn't even expecting
this.
Damn, I know we from on the fight. You can't be swinging for real, man. Cisco,
you not gonna
fuck out, man.
I can't be hitting
me for real, man. They gotta
hit
me on the fucking
stand.
You
know,
you got work and
you
got work too. I got 9
punches for both of niggas. Calm down. I'm sorry about the little scuffle, but that's what happens sometimes, you know what I'm saying? Let's keep the party going, DJ. Let's go.
It's tripping.
Let's go.
Do this shit and do this shit right for 5 minutes. Get it over with.
He's
going to my fucking head.
Stare down. Do not touch now.
Can we?
That's it.
Can we?
Don't kiss now.
Don't kiss.
Apollo, who you got? Who you got, Apollo?
But he'll stand up, nigga, though. I'm with him. He's supposed to be with him, but he'll stand up. Even though I'm going to fuck Cisco up.
Nothing. You going down. Hurt him now. Hurt him. Keep my time. Keep my faith. Keep my fire.
If you heard you was going to go out, are you going to box also?
Yeah, they can put me on with Rich Dollar. Sign the paperwork. Put the paperwork together. Let's go. Rich Dollar, you want some work? I'll give you that work.
Right. Man, you gonna put your hands on that Aaron Carter? You think he's gonna be ready for you? Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
What do you think happened in there tonight?
It's like work, man. You know, we faced off. I knew he wanted to get me. I put up an Instagram post, and he was really upset about an Instagram post I put up with him. He was in. I thought he was in seat 81C. Turns out they put him in the bathroom on the wing or some shit. And he was mad that I posted that. He was in worst class. I was in first class. But that's my nigga, though. You know, at the end, that's my little brother. I'm going to spank him for 3 rounds, and I'm going to kiss him, and we're going to go pause.
Come on.
Kiss him on that lump on his head, and we're going to go drink after the fight. But for now, we're going to mix it up a little bit. I love him.
So are you at all worried?
Not my enemy. Huh?
Are you at all worried?
Hell no. If I was worried, I wouldn't fight. I mean, I'm from the South Bronx, man. I've seen getting in the ring with thick gloves on, with cushions on him for three rounds, ain't nothing compared to what I seen growing up in the Bronx. Why would I be worried about that? Even if I was gonna take a L, why would I be worried about that? But that's not. Cisco is mad, he's gonna go for the heavy knockout. He gonna try to knock me out. He got asthma, he'll be wheezing by the second round, and then I'm beat him like the little drummer boy.
Rup-a-bum-bum. Say, getting spanked out.
Yeah, that's my little brother.
That's a BX spanking.
It's in the name of love. You ever spank your kid and go and feel bad because you spanked them because they did some bad shit? That's the same. It's no different. You know how your kid do some shit and you spank them and you crying because you spanked them? It's the same shit. I love him, man. I love him. He a hard-headed motherfucker, man. He clear this up. He called me out. I'm not no boxer. In fact, they offering me other fights right now after this one. I'm like, this is a one and done for me. This motherfucker wanted, he already got his next opponents planned out like I don't exist. He want to continue on.
After this one, he ain't gonna want no more. After this one,
this nigga became a boxer at like 41. He want to become a boxer. He crazy. I'm 52. I'm out of here, baby. I'm gonna put hands on him. The old man gonna show him what it is, and then I'm going home. So I'm too old for this shit. I will never train like this again. I want to drink. I want to smoke my cigars. And this nigga took me off my cigars and my drinks for 2 months. Fuck me all up. I'm miserable right now. Because he called me out. But we going to get it done and get it over with. I'll fuck him up for 3 rounds. It's a challenge. I like a challenge. You know what I mean? That's all. I'm talking a lot. Nobody asked me no questions. I'm interviewing myself.
Well, nah, you got us on. That's what we want.
So what the hell was that when you hit his ass first, though? What was all that about, man?
When I hit him first?
Yeah, goddamn. You kind of just started doing
it. In the Bronx, it's a certain thing you do that show you trying to do something. You got to read a person. If a person goes like this, or if a person is looking back, it's certain moves a person make that say, oh, they want to be the first one. So I called him first. Hey, and he called me back the second time. His team say, yo, we give you my word. Just them Brooklyn. Don't ever listen to a motherfucker from Brooklyn. Woo! Gave me his word on his mother and still swung on me.
So are you worried about the fight?
Not at all.
Why are you so confident in
it? I mean, you know, it's not confidence. It's just that when you grow up in an environment like the South Bronx, fighting somebody with cushion gloves on for 3 rounds is nothing.
Yeah.
You know
your
mean?
First time boxing?
I had beef with shooters. I had beef. That's what I was worried about. I had beef with shooters, and I had to call my people. Had to call my people and make sure we was good so I could go to the store. I had that type of beef. This is just your little brother saying, it's over, man. You ain't going to just... And he taking his training wheels off, and he's showing me that he a man, and I just got to show him you still ain't ready yet, man. You need the training wheels. You're bugging.
So how are you preparing for this fight?
All right, y'all. The champ is off.
So I'm really in shock, y'all. I cannot imagine all of that just took place. I'm going to get out the way before I get demonetized, but yeah. So you make sure y'all check out the rest of my videos on my YouTube channel. I know it's a lot going on, but I'll show y'all my recap once I get to the fight, if I make it to the fight, because I might not be gone. But whether I'm going or not, it doesn't really matter because y'all get to watch the videos online. So make sure y'all hit like, subscribe, most importantly, hit the bell, because if you don't hit the bell, you won't see the rest of my videos. All right, y'all, we out.
Radio.com.